Welcome to ELH 4x4 Doing Stuff. Today we're working on a 2012 F350 XLT Super Duty. Turbo diesel, 6.7 liter power stroke. That doesn't really matter because we're doing rear brakes. Come along. Alright, so we got to find a good place to jack it up at, right? Looks good. All right, so the next step is to pull the center cap off. Start breaking these loose. And then we'll get the jack stand out. And this is a 21 millimeter. Jack it up. Place the jack stand right underneath the spring. Let's get this tire off. Get you in here, see what we're looking at. I gotta take that off. Down there. All right, so we'll use 16 millimeter. Pardon me, didn't mean to hit you. Let's get you better. Better angle. Top and bottom bolts are the same exact size. All right, I'm going to go get a bungee cord to hang this caliper so it's not putting stress on this flexible brake hose. I'll be right back. Apply some pressure on a caliper to open it up a little bit. Probably have to get a pry bar. Thank you.
That is insane. There we go. Ooh, somebody's getting some. All right. So, while we're in here, take a look at this boot. Boot looks a little bit destroyed here. Like it got behind the brake pad. While we use a bungee cord. Rear brakes look pretty good. I don't know what the customer was talking about. Let's compare them with the new ones. They look almost identical. Well, I mean in thickness. Let's get this caliper squared away. That boot's gonna have to be tucked away. All right. What I use is a dental pick, but you have to be very careful. Not to damage it. See, there's a groove in the piston that the seal goes around, just like on this side. All right, just had to explain to the owner, you know, what was going on. And, you know, what he was concerned about stopping power, obviously, right? We're all concerned about stopping. No, but stopping power. He just said it wasn't there, and so we'll change these brakes out and see what happens. Wire brush. Continue to work with this caliper, and I can put the new brake pads in. So we just make sure that the brake pads are exactly the same. The clips go on one way. That's all we got to do. So we take the new stuff. Sure. Well, what I like to do too is make sure they're not binding inside the mount. Put a little lube on these clips. Just a little bit. access. Now the clips are set up for left and right side of the vehicle. Just be sure that you don't interchange them. So what I like to do is before you completely tear stuff down is, you know, leave some of this stuff together that you have a reference to go to later to find out, you know, what goes where. And trying to get my big old head in the way here so you guys can see what's going on. There you go. Yeah. Alright, that slides pretty good. Alright, let me take the time to clean this hardware up. Make sure it's lubricated. That was close. I'm glad the engineers thought about that. Can you guys see that? How close that is to the leaf spring? Just give that a little spin. Put it back on, make sure it's seated properly. start working on that caliper now. See if we can't push that down a little and start working on getting that dust boot. What's up with that? It's a little bit excessive. Oh. There we go. So luckily it's going back in. It's kind of hard to tell. Get another C-clamp, see what we can do. Itself. Take a measurement here. Let's see how this works. I just need a rough guesstimation here. Maybe. Maybe that might be pushed in. I don't know. I don't know if that's bottomed out or... I've never seen... piston sticking out that far. That might be the problem. Piston might be seized. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go step on the brake and see if we get some movement. Looks like that one side moved, huh? That one might be seized because that dust boot actually used to do its job until it was compromised. So we'll see. All right, so I came to the conclusion that this caliper's no good. So you can see, definitely see the difference here. So what I'm gonna do is I'll do another test. All right, you got it to move. I'm going to peel this back. See what we're working with. Yeah. These aren't phenolic, these are metal pistons, and there's clearly some rust buildup on the piston. due to a compromised dust shield. Try to push it back in. That's where it stops, right there. So he needs a new caliper. Move this one over. So hardly with any effort at all, this piston pushes back inside. The caliper. Alright, so what I'll do is, go notify the owner and see what he wants to do from there. All right, this is what's up. I'm going to button this side back up with the old, well, not even really. Nah, I'm just gonna kind of put stuff back together so I can take a look at the other side and see what that's doing. And this would explain why he had decreased braking power. All because of a compromised dust seal. it's not going anywhere. All right, let's move on to the other side. All right, let's get into this right side. See what we got. Right, I had a little bit of difficulty. Moving this piston over. On the other side. This side seems to be moving just a little bit easier, which is a good sign. I switched over to a different mount to get you guys in there a little bit tighter. What is up with that? Same thing, man. Whoever did brakes on this thing, that's the seal. So this seal's compromised too, so. Oh, man. All right, I'm gonna have to switch over to a different mount. All right. See if this one pushes in. It looks like it has more meat than the new one. It sure does. Let's see if we get any movement out of this caliper. See, that's how it's supposed to go in. And I don't like that boot. I'm gonna go pick up a new caliper and then take the good boot off of the other side and put it on here. Unbelievable. How hard is it to check to make sure that that seal isn't hanging over? It's all it is. Right there. That's a little bit rusty too. See, the dirt gets inside there. All that crusty garbage gets inside. And there's a seal, a couple of seals inside the caliper that the piston ride on. That's such a close tolerance that any kind of dirt, debris, especially rust, will seize that piston right up. So we're going to get this area cleaned out. And yeah, we'll take it from there. Probably hit that with a little bit of air. I'm gonna try not to breathe that garbage in. All right, so I got the other seal out. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit it up with some penetrating. Penetrating oil. Bear with me, people. You know, sometimes I don't finish complete sentences and whatnot. But some of you, you know where the story's going, so. A lot of the chunky rust out. That way it doesn't get in between the piston and the caliper and cause it to seize up. Sounds good to me. Alright, let's get back into the fight. I'm trying to get my bearings about me. A lot of redundancy, taking tires off, putting tires on. And just to go back and forth from one side to the other, so. Kind of winded right now. Plus, it's kind of hot outside. All right. Let's see if we got you in frame here. How's that working out for you? All right. So that's it. We just need to make sure we get that seal in there. Once you kind of get that backside in there first. Then you can start working the other edges in. Careful.